Hey guys, what's up? In this video, we are going to prove these two formulae. So let us start with the first one, that is Laplace of sine hyperbolic at equals to a upon sa square minus a square. So here f of t equals to what? Sine hyperbolic at. Okay, we are going to use, again we are using the standard formula, or you can say the general formula for Laplace transform, that is Laplace of f of t equals to integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus st into f of t dt. We are going to use this formula. So Laplace of sine hyperbolic a t, this equals to integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus st into sine hyperbolic a t dt. Okay, you must be knowing one formula, that is sine hyperbolic a t equals to e to the power a t minus e to the power minus a t upon 2. Okay, we are going to use this formula. Fine. Okay, let's see. This equals to integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t bracket open e to the power a t minus e to the power minus a t upon 2 dt. Taking this half outside of this integration, we will get 1 upon 2 integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t e to the power a t dt minus half integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t into e to the power minus a t dt. Okay, fine. Let us try to solve this and this one by one. Half integration 0 to infinity, taking half common. Okay, let us take half common. This will become e to the power, taking this negative common. Okay, we get minus, and t also taking, we are taking t also common. So this is s minus a times t. Okay, taking minus t common, we get minus t s minus a. Okay, now this is dt. Fine. Similarly, 0 to integration 0 to infinity e to the power, taking minus t common, you will get s plus a times t. Okay, again this is dt. Fine. Now integrating this with respect to t, we will get half, this is e to the power minus s minus a times t upon minus s minus a minus e to the power minus s plus a times t upon minus s plus a. Limit goes from 0 to infinity. Okay, putting this upper limit here, we will get, taking this minus 1 upon s minus a common, putting this infinity here, we'll get e to the power minus infinity, e to the power minus infinity. Putting this 0 here, you will get e to the power 0, minus e to the power 0. Okay, now solve this, minus minus, it will become plus. Taking this denominator common, that is s plus a. Okay, now putting this upper limit here in place of t, you will get e to the power minus infinity, minus, put this 0 here in place of t, you will get e to the power 0. Okay, now this value becomes 0 and this value also becomes 0. E to the power 0, e to the power 0 becomes 1. So this will be half, this is minus 1 times minus 1 upon s minus a will become 1 upon s minus a. This is minus 1 and this is plus 1, this is minus 1 upon s plus a. Taking this LCM, s square minus a square, this is s plus a minus s plus a. S will become cancelled, so this is twice a upon s square minus a square. Okay, now this half here, 2 gets cancelled, so this is a upon s square minus a square. hence proved. That is, Laplace of sine hyperbolic at equals to a upon s square minus a square. The first part is over. Let us try to prove the second part. That is, Laplace of cos hyperbolic at equals to s upon s square minus a square. Okay, so let us start solving the second part. F of t equals to cos hyperbolic a t. Okay, so Laplace of cos hyperbolic a t equals to integration 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t into cos hyperbolic a t dt. Okay, so you must be knowing one formula, that is cos hyperbolic a t equals to e to the power a t plus e to the power minus a t upon 2. Okay, we are going to use this formula here. Now this becomes 0 to infinity e to the power minus s t bracket open e to the power a t plus e to the power minus a t upon 2 into dt. Okay, taking this half common, you will get integration 0 to infinity e to the power this is minus st, this is a t, so taking minus t common, that is s minus a times t. Okay, this becomes dt. Again plus integration 0 to infinity, again this is minus, this is minus, so e to the power minus, this is s plus a times t, this is dt. Okay, fine, close this bracket. Half, this is integrating e to the power minus s minus a times t upon minus of s minus a, again plus e to the power minus s plus a times t upon minus of s plus a. Limit goes from 0 to infinity. Okay, now put in the upper limit and lower limit, you will get, taking this common, that is 1 upon minus 1 upon s minus a, this is putting infinity in place of t, you will get e to the power minus infinity, e to the power minus infinity, put this 0 over t, you will get e to the power 0. Okay, now this is minus 1 upon s plus a, put this infinity in place of t, you will get e to the power minus infinity minus e to the power 0. Okay, close it. This becomes 0 and this becomes 0. Fine. Now this is 1 upon 2. This becomes minus 1. 1 minus 1 minus 1 will become 1. 1 upon s minus a. This is minus 1. This is also minus. This will become 1 upon plus 1 upon s plus a. Taking LCM, 1 upon 2. LCM is s square minus a square, s plus a plus s minus a. A gets cancelled. This will be half into 2s upon s square minus a square. 2 gets cancelled. So here we will get s upon s square minus a square. So you can see that the second part is also proved. That is cos hyperbolic a t equals to s upon s square minus a square. So hence proved. Okay, so if you like this video, then don't forget to hit the like button and please share this video with your friends. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you.